I think the key thing that the Food Safety Modernization Act does is establish a foundation for food production in this country that's based on hazard analysis and preventive controls, so that all food processors and food producers understand their responsibility for producing safe food. In the past few years, we've seen a number of large and very high profile multi-state outbreaks of foodborne disease caused by Salmonella and E. coli 0157. And those outbreaks have happened in a context that we've got fractured oversight of the industry with multiple federal agencies, multiple state agencies, and in some cases no clear authority or mandate for oversight of food production in this country. So because of the continuing occurrence of these large outbreaks, there's been a desire to try to create a more systematic and consistent approach to the regulation of our food supply. There aren't a lot of things that are going to happen overnight. The provisions of the bill are going to require funding. There's a lot of rulemaking authority, and so we'll see changes occurring gradually over time. And so what the consumer may see in the near term is some increase in prices, because some of the provisions of the act will necessarily lead to increased cost of food production, and it would be surprising if some of those costs weren't passed on to the consumer. But that should be viewed as a good thing, because we need to invest in food safety, and ultimately it should lead to less cost of illness being also borne by the public. Well, I think ultimately, if food is made safer in this country, then we all win. The consumers win, the producers win, and we have a healthier population.